Hi everyone, welcome back to Millennial Daddy PH. So this is a channel all about parenting, no? Anything you need para mag-transition from a bachelor or a bachelorette to a full-fledged parent. So today, pag-uusapan natin yung some updates on the Lear Fund or the Levi's Education and Early Retirement Fund. Yan, so that's Levi, ano yan, sneak peek. So yeah, pinag-uusapan natin ang Lear Fund, and if you don't know what that is, I have some 3 videos na ano, ginawa ko dati. It's about DIY investing. Do check that out if you have time. Also, one quick tip, I found out recently na I think mas maganda yung viewing experience mo kapag fina-fast forward mo yung video, no? So you can do that by pressing a shift greater than sign. Hopefully that tip helps. Now on with the video. So in my past 3 videos about DIY investing, di ba pinag-usapan natin na hindi lahat ng tao ganun ka-aggressive when it comes to investing their money. I myself found out during the pandemic na yung ano ko pala, yung aking appetite as an investor falls between yung aggressive at saka yung conservative. Now, we did some digging, di ba? Ano yung mga alternatives sa traditional investing? And here's what we found out. So, this is yung cute baby ko. So, say hi to Levi. Yan. Yan. So, ito yung mga nakita natin, no? So, you can read yung mga ibang mga nahanap natin na investment models or vehicles, no? But, ang gusto ko lang i-point out dito is yung dalawang napili natin, no? So, the traditional way of investing at saka yung risk parity model. So, ito kasi, marami kang kinoconsider na factors when becoming a passive investor. Means yung mga iba kasi dito, it's very complex. Tapos, marami kang kinocompute. So, ayaw natin yun. So, yung risk parity na yung isa sa mga pinakasimpleng investment models na nahanap natin. And yun yung gusto natin pag-eksperimentohan kung gagana ba siya compared dun sa traditional way of investing. Some of the factors considered is active, ano ka ba? Active investor ka ba? Or passive? So, kung active ka, pwede mong i-check out yung iba. Pero ako, since passive investor ako, I'm just sticking with the risk parity at saka yung traditional asset allocation. Ano yung goals mo sa buhay, di ba? So, ask yourself that. Minention natin yun dun sa ating personal finance na ano, na isang video. Ano yung risk appetite mo, like we mentioned before? Ano yung investment beliefs mo? So, yun yung mga key considerations when picking your investment model. So, comparing the two, no? So, let's just focus our attention dun sa dilaw at saka dun sa pula na linya. So, the yellow one is your pure total stock market index sa US, and yung red is a sample risk parity style portfolio. As you can see, ang right off the bat, ang difference talaga ni risk parity compared kay US is that mas maganda yung risk versus reward ni risk parity model. It's as reflected sa Sharpe ratio. So Sharpe ratio is the indicator kung gaano kaganda yung reward versus risk ng isang portfolio. So 0.8 kay risk parity, higher than the 0.55. And this is also reflected doon sa yung maximum drawdown. So ano yung pinakamalaking dip na na-experience itong portfolio mo throughout the years, no? So from 1994 all the way to 2020, ang golden ratio portfolio only experienced 1/4 drawdown, no? 24% drawdown sa pinakamalalang time, whereas yung US total stock market index, yung VTI, is 50%, nangalahati siya. But in exchange, kung titingnan natin yung performance, di ba, yung efficacy ng portfolio, you can see na si JL Collins or the US total stock market index is 10.10%. Pre-inflation to, hindi pa siya inflation adjusted, 10.10% a year yung kanyang compounded annual growth rate compared sa 9.17 ni golden ratio. So kung nag-invest ka ng $10,000 noong 1994, right now, ang iyong $10,000 sa 2020 would be $106,731 for the golden ratio and $134,373 for the JL Collins. So those are some considerations for you, and pwede mong tignan itong graph na to see kung kamusta, kung makakatiis ka ba na hindi mag-withdraw throughout the years, di ba? Given yung maximum drawdown. So yun yung main comparison talaga ni risk parity compared kay ano, US total stock market index, no? So it's up to you to decide kung ano ba ang ano mo, panlasa mo bilang isang investor. So that's why we're ano, doing this right now. Isa kasi sa mga disadvantages ni risk parity is it's a relatively new investment model, no? So walang masyado empirical data to back up yung claims niya na ano, mataas ang kanyang ano, reward versus risk talaga, and highly dependent siya doon sa correlation factors. Kasi 'di ba, as you can recall doon sa pinag-usapan natin dati, ang risk parity portfolio is dependent on these key principles, 'di ba? Yung Ray Dalio's Holy Grail principle, maghahanap ka ng 4 to 5 uncorrelated asset classes. Kung medyo worthy 'yon for you, bumalik ka doon sa isang previous video ko na ano, about DIY investing, yung episode 3-1. And yun, and it's supposed to be ano, for kids. So yun yung isa sa abbreviation natin. You have to keep your investments diversified and simple. So this is done through indexing and ETFs. So in theory, ang gusto natin gawin dito is to have a safe withdrawal rate of 5%. So when we say that, ang ano yun, ang safe withdrawal rate is tinatanggalan mo ng 5% yung portfolio mo each year, and you will retain yung kanyang initial value even after 30 years or more. So depende dun sa performance niya. So ganun siya in theory, no? So punta tayo dun sa performance, no? Sa performance niya actually. So you can pause this video. This is a table summarizing kung ano ba yung trade-offs between the traditional investing at saka risk parity, no? So ano naman, very self-explanatory. So dito tayo sa meat of our discussion. So gumawa tayo ng 5 portfolios, experimental portfolios, na gamit yung education fund ni Levi. So we put 50k in each, so that's $1,000 in each portfolio. So you have your aggressive 50-50 and accelerated permanent portfolio. These are your aggressive AF na ano, na portfolio. So ano sila, may tinatawag sila na leverage funds, no? So pag-usapan na lang natin yun na future video. But for now, just keep in mind na these are very aggressive risk parity style portfolios na ano, na ginagamit natin. Golden Ratio and Cyborg Butterfly are the medium sweet spot na ano, na risk parity parity portfolios. They balance yung returns at saka yung risk. So this is good for medium risk investors. Tapos yung BTI, yung total US total stock market index, ito yung baseline natin. Dito dapat natin binabangga yung performance at saka yung risk nung ibang risk parity portfolios. So through the months, we will do a monthly report. So right now, yung aggressive 50-50 is down 7.63, yung APP negative 7.10. Ang best performer this ano month is yung Cyborg Butterfly, negative 3.26 lang yung bagsak. Golden Ratio, negative 3.58, and our baseline is negative 4.11. So the last ano, the last column is an indicator, no, kung magkano yung kaya mong withdrawin given a 5% safe withdrawal rate, no. So assuming na may ano, instead of 50,000 pesos, ginawa natin 10 million pesos to. Assuming some years from now, retired ka na, you have 10 million pesos, nilagay mo siya dito sa mga portfolios na to. Ito yung pwede mong i-withdraw on a monthly basis sa kanya. Assuming a 5% safe withdrawal rate. Tapos hindi mauubos yung pera mo. In theory, ah. So, disclaimer guys, hindi ako financial advisor. I do these things to give you information and to transform your lives as ano, no, as millennial parents to make your own decisions. And but please do your own due diligence. Huwag yung gawing sole reference itong video na to. So this is for information and sometimes entertainment purposes only. Ayan. So eto, tingnan nyo. Yan yung mga pwede nyo i-withdraw. Hindi naman sila nalalayo. Tapos, I'll just browse through this. You can pause the video para malaman nyo kung ano yung mga ETF names na ginamit ko. Yung naka-highlight dito na mga small boxes, eto yung dito kayo kukuha nung ano, nung monthly withdrawal rates yung pag ginagawa nyo siyang retirement portfolio. So for this ano, particular case, hindi muna tayo mag-withdraw kasi hindi naman natin kailangan yung pera. So titingnan lang natin yung performance niya. So that's the September report for the risk parity experiment. If you have some questions about it, pwede natin siyang pag-usapan in future monthly reports. No? So we're going to do this monthly. Kakamustahin natin yung performance ng bawat portfolio. Kunwari, invested na talaga tayo, nilagay natin lahat ng pera natin dun sa mga portfolios na yun. Ano yung magiging itsura nung ano natin, investment natin? Magugutom ba tayo or ano, mag-grow ba ang portfolio natin? So, yun yung mga aabangan natin. So, if you found this video helpful, I would appreciate it if you give it a thumbs up, a like. So, it will help the other parents to see this video, no? Kasi yung algorithm ni YouTube, ito naman, ayoko na mag-over-explain. Thank you. Basta like if you like the content. Yun lang. Thank you, guys.